Once upon a time in midwinter, when the snowflakes were falling like feathers from heaven, a duchess sat sewing at her window, which had a frame of black ebony wood. As she sewed, she looked up at the snow and pricked her finger with her needle.
Shit!
Three drops of blood fell onto the snow. The red on the white looked so beautiful that she thought to herself,
if I only had a child as white as snow, as red as blood, and as black as the wood in this frame.
That can be arranged.
You again?
Good morrow, dear Gretchen.
I thought I'd gotten rid of you.
You thought wrong.
But you lost the wager.
May I not visit with the esteemed champion from time to time?
I'm sure you didn't pop in here just to chat. What do you want?
To fulfill your desire, a child as white as snow, as red as blood, as black as ebony.
No, don't do me any favors. There are always strings attached to your gifts.
You will beget a healthy, robust girl child, quite good-looking, too, no charge.
Where are you doing this?
Not a genius, you understand?
Come on, I know there's a fine print. Out with it.
Oh, of course. You can take the maiden out of the mill, but you cannot take the mill out of the maiden.
I'm not a mill lass anymore. I'm a duchess. I wield power. You had best mind your step with me.
Consider, Gretchen, now that you can no longer spin straw into gold, how long do you fancy that you'll remain the duchess?
I'm bearing the duke's child.
A girl child. He wants a son and heir.
I'll bear him a son one day.
No, you won't. Not unless you act more agreeably to me.
What have you to say about it?
Everything.
Oh, shit.
Mark me. Canon law forbids public divorce, but approves secret murder. No gold, no son. What's left? To hold on to your title and your life, you had best be very skilled in bed.
Double shit.
Not one of your accomplishments.
Eh? Wherefore do you torment me? What do you want?
Same as always. Child.
You cannot have the child. Our agreement...
Which I happen to have right here. It does stipulate in paragraph 8C that having guessed my name, you are absolved of your responsibility to relinquish your firstborn to me. But nowhere does it prevent me from acquiring the child by other means. See for yourself.
You think you can spirit her out of the castle?
Fie, woman, what do you take me for, a common cut purse?
Exactly how do you intend to acquire my baby?
That's my business. Just remember, there are diverse means of flaying a feline.
Over my dead body!
That, too, can be arranged.
Blackstone Audio presents the Hollywood Theater of the Ear production of Yuri Rasovsky's Die, Snow White, Die, Damn You.
Lords and ladies of the Duchy of Bonchesvaig, we, your sovereign duke, thank you for attending our combined memorial for our hapless late duchess and wedding feast for our beautiful new duchess. As befits the occasion, I have prepared a few remarks. Though yet of Gretchen, our dear wife's death, the memory be green, and that it us befitted to bear our hearts in grief, and our whole dukedom to be contracted in one brow of woe. Yet so far hath discretion fought with nature that we, with wisest sorrow, think on her together with remembrance of ourselves. Therefore, our beautiful new duchess...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.